Hi guys, how are you doing today? This is what we're going to be starting to do every evening. I'm going to share a poem. This is a poem that is very it's dedicated to Kanika, and it's also dedicated to all of the people that we have lost through violence in America. And it's called Senseless Violence in America Continues. Again, it is from one of my favorite sites. I'm gonna go ahead and share it. I tried to do it with my face on the camera, but it took me 2 times and I couldn't stop crying and I could hardly get it out. So I'm just going to do it this way. The source is again Hub Pages. The eyes of innocence shine brightly before becoming dimmed by the horrors of violence. This poem is dedicated to all the families in America who have lost someone to a senseless violent act. Each day, our sensibilities are over and over again assaulted by the breaking news reported in the media about the loss of another innocent fellow human being. Whether it's a 6-year-old child just beginning to grasp the wonders of life, or a middle-aged man snuffed out days before retirement, the losses are all tragic. When will it stop? When will we go for 1 week and not hear about another domestic terror attack, school shootings, deadly robbery, or violent home invasions ending in death? Where can we feel safe? I offer no answers to these rhetorical questions, I'm sorry. Only a word of validating comfort and a shared grief as a member of my community. By acknowledging the pain families are experiencing across the country, a message of solidarity is sent that you are not alone and we share your loss. Until we find a way to teach the value of human life in the midst of our need to express anger, frustration, disillusionment, we will remain at the mercy of violent expression that so often ends in sudden death. In the meantime, we can embrace each other with a collective hug of compassion and prayer for ourselves, our deceased loved ones, and for the souls of those who will continue to perpetrate senseless violence upon innocent people. Now, I am going to give you guys something that I wrote. In response to this poem. So give me a minute. While most of us grow up thinking our country as a safe and protected place to live, it is events such as these that remind us that no one is exempt from senseless acts of violence. It is unfortunate that it takes such reminders for people to mobilize against these issues, gun control, hate crime, discrimination, terrorism, and that innocent lives are lost at the expense of a select few or a single individual. It is frustrating to see that while family members and loved ones suffer their losses, the rest of the world reacts with an apologetic and passionate response that seems to work towards reform and recovery to help prevent another violent act in the future. Yet sometimes the reforms never take shape and points out recovery are never reached. my only hope is that after these domestic instances that surround issues, those previously mentioned as well as others, began to take precedence in our nation's political and societal debates. Waiting to take action will only cost us more lives and more unnecessary grief for our own country's citizens and also the rest of the world. And hearing about the instances in Colorado and Wisconsin, and as they occur with such proximity of one another, and as they occur with such proximity of one another, my attention circles around the realities of such violence and how anyone could have been a victim. To the families currently suffering, I wish you the greatest of strength during this time. Though we can grieve as a nation, we only catch a glimpse of the sadness and despair you are now experiencing every day. I sincerely hope that you remain, that you are reminded of all the support sent your way directly or spiritually just as often. Another poem that I'm going to share is for Miss Teresa and Kanika. The sacrificial lamb of innocence. Now, I know that there are some disagreements on whether people should refer Kanika as a baby girl. To me, being a mother that is 45 years old, and this sweetheart was only 19, in my mind, she is a baby girl. She is a young woman. However, she is someone's baby, and that is Miss Teresa's. And she can be all of our babies. We all have a Kanika in our families. And so to me, she is always going to be considered a baby girl. The Sacrificial Lamb of Innocence. You can find this on Hub Pages as well, guys. Slice the slaughter of the innocent. In the land of life and liberty, a country of brotherly love, a melting pot of diversity and acceptance. Murder wreaks havoc in the land of plenty, lives taken in a blink of an eye, and I once looking far and forward to achieving that American dream. Violence is winning while young boys and innocent girls are losing, no longer free to pursue goals, created by an early fate of death. The cruel sacrifice a mother makes, losing her innocent lamb, off to school, to the corner store, a playground, or to a movie theater. My heart bleeds tears of sorrow as I hear the latest news of another slain victim. This poem also goes out to OTE, the activist in Chicago who was also murdered, fighting for justice for Kanika. It also goes out to Samaje Crosby. It goes out to Jordan Bilbo. It goes out to Ashanti Davis. It goes out to Charlene Avila. And anyone else that I may have missed, I want you guys to look at these pictures and see the innocence that she still had in her eyes. Kanika was just beginning to live. No matter what her mistakes may have been, she was 19 years old.
And it does not matter whether she was drinking because she wanted to. It does not matter because she supposedly went to a movie and went to a party. It does not matter how she was dressed, how she was acting. That is not the reason why she was taken away from her family. That is not why she was taken away from the world. She was not able to contribute to society, to make differences in people's lives. We don't know what Kanika would have been. Sorry, guys. But I want you guys to remember that she was a wonderful soul. So wonderful that those of us who really care about her really, really want to know what happened. Those of us who really care about her want to see the people who did these things to her punished. Look into her eyes, guys, and feel her. Feel what Miss Teresa is feeling. Try to step into her shoes for a minute. After you guys see this video, this is the one time that I really want you guys to put in the comments, I am Kanika. I love y'all. And I hope that everyone has a wonderful night. And I will see you guys tomorrow. I love y'all. Good night.